إذا قرئ القرآن فاستمعوا له وأنصتوا لعلكم ترحمون.
إذا قرئ القرآن فاستمعوا له وأنصتوا لعلكم ترحمون.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. Welcome to Quran Circle 3, where we take a surah every time, an entire surah. We listen to its recitation. We try to reflect upon the meaning and gain the blessings of listening to the Quran. Listening to the Quran is something that we should really change in our life, that every day we should try to listen to something of the Quran. We should recite ourselves every day a portion of the Quran. We should reflect upon the meanings. We should act according to the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And in this episode, inshallah ta'ala, we'll talk about Surah An-Nur, the light. After Surah Al-Mu'minun, the believers, then the light comes after it. And we're all in need of the light, that we would be able to see in the midst of the darknesses that are present on the face of earth. It's not just one darkness, but darknesses. And the only light is the light of the Quran and the Sunnah, the way of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And that's what we need to really seek and earn, so that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make us steadfast on the straight path till we meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Before inshallah ta'ala we start, I would like to introduce our reciters, starting from the right side, Sheikh Karim Al-Hariri. Welcome to the program. And we have also Sheikh Ahmad Rajab.
Welcome.
And Sheikh Mahmoud Noor.
You're welcome.
We are very honored to have them with us today. And inshallah ta'ala we'll listen to their recitation. This beautiful surah, Surah An-Nur, has many rulings. And it's important really for us to learn it and to comprehend it. And that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala started with the surah by saying that it's suratun anzalnaha wa faradnaha. This is a surah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought down to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and it's made an obligation because it protects our chastity, protects our households, protects our religion, our deen, and it exposes the ways of the hypocrites, as it happened at the time of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and many other great benefits and rulings and etiquettes towards the end of the surah, and submission to the orders of Allah and the way of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So we'll try inshallah ta'ala to reflect upon that after we listen to the beautiful recitations. And we'll start inshallah ta'ala with the recitation from Sheikh Karim. So please go ahead, start from the beginning of the surah.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. سورة أنزلناها وفرضناها وأنزلنا فيها آيات بينات لعلكم تذكرون. الزانية والزاني فاجلدوا كل واحد منهما 100 جلدة ولا تأخذكم بهما رأفة في دين الله إن كنتم تؤمنون بالله واليوم الآخر وليشهد عذابهما طائفة من المؤمنين. الزاني لا ينكح إلا زانية أو مشركة والزانية لا ينكحها إلا زان أو مشرك وحرم ذلك على المؤمنين. والذين يرمون المحصنات ثم لم يأتوا 4 شهداء فاجلدوهم 80 جلدة ولا تقبلوا لهم شهادة أبدا وأولئك هم الفاسقون. إلا الذين تابوا من بعد ذلك وأصلحوا فإن الله غفور رحيم. والذين يرمون أزواجهم ولم يكن لهم شهداء إلا أنفسهم فشهادة أحدهم أربع شهادات بالله إنه لمن الصادقين. والخامسة أن لعنة الله عليه إن كان من الكاذبين. ويدرأ عنها العذاب أن تشهد أربع شهادات بالله إنه لمن الكاذبين. والخامسة أن غضب الله عليها إن كان من الصادقين. ولولا فضل الله عليكم ورحمته وأن الله تواب حكيم. إن الذين جاءوا بالإفك عصبة منكم لا تحسبوه شرا لكم بل هو خير لكم لكل امرئ منهم ما اكتسب من الإثم والذي تولى كبره منهم له عذاب عظيم. لولا إذ سمعتموه ظن المؤمنون والمؤمنات بأنفسهم خيرا وقالوا هذا إفك مبين. لولا جاءوا عليه بأربعة شهداء فإذ لم يأتوا بالشهداء فأولئك عند الله هم الكاذبون. ولولا فضل الله عليكم ورحمته في الدنيا والآخرة لمسكم فيما أفضتم فيه عذاب عظيم. إذ تلقونه بألسنتكم وتقولون بأفواهكم ما ليس لكم به علم وتحسبونه هينا وهو عند الله عظيم. ولولا إذ سمعتموه قلتم ما يكون لنا أن نتكلم بهذا سبحانك هذا بهتان عظيم. يعظكم الله أن تعودوا لمثله أبدا إن كنتم مؤمنين. ويبين الله لكم الآيات والله عليم حكيم. إن الذين يحبون أن تشيع الفاحشة في الذين آمنوا لهم عذاب أليم في الدنيا والآخرة والله يعلم وأنتم لا تعلمون. ولولا فضل الله عليكم ورحمته وأن الله رؤوف رحيم.
ما شاء الله. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you for this beautiful recitation. The beginning of Surah An-Nur, the beginning of the light that is mentioned in the Surah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reveals to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam certain rulings to protect the Muslim community, the Muslim society, from one of the evil crimes that once it spread, it brings all kinds of miseries for people in this life and in the hereafter, which is the crime of zina or fornication. And that's why the capital punishment, or the punishment that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prescribed for the people in charge, for the people of authority to implement in the society, is mentioned in the beginning of the surah. And that this evil action, it takes away from the iman, it weakens the iman of the person. And that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala invite all mankind and the believers to repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it's mentioned in more than one place in the Quran. One of the important concepts when it comes to the sins in the deen of Islam, even if the person committed a sin is a sin, it's a crime, it's an evil thing. And if a person does this, he subjects himself to the punishment of Allah. And it brings the wrath of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this life and in the hereafter. But if a person repents to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most forgiving and he's the most merciful subhanahu wa ta'ala. Another crime is mentioned, which is the crime of qadhf al-muhsanat, to slander the believing chaste women, to slander them, to accuse them of this evil crime of zina. This is something that is so evil, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the surah, and the punishment for such a person to say something with one's mouth, a word that a person can simply get it out of his system, but it's something that makes one of the destructive sins, that there's a severe punishment, humiliating punishment in this life, and a severe punishment in the day of judgment, except for those who repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But one of the ways, or the verses explained when it comes between the husband and the wife, and the ruling of al-mula'ana, or so that if a man accuses his wife of zina, he doesn't have to bring the witnesses, and instead they would separate themselves if they both would swear in front of the judge in a very particular way. And this is not the time really to discuss all the details, but it shows how perfect is the deen of Allah to protect every right that a person has in this life, and to protect ourselves from the evil within our own selves. And how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made this crime, it's such an evil one, but for the people to find out something like this, it's also very difficult to find. Four witnesses have to witness the act itself, otherwise they will be accused of slandering, which makes it difficult. And it's meant to be this way so that the fahisha, or this evil doing, does not spread in a society. And that's why for it to be concealed better than it to be exposed. And of course there's the story of Aisha radiallahu anha, the mother of the believers, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed verses from above the seven heavens to claim or to make it clear, stating clearly the innocence of Aisha radiallahu anha, and those who accuse Aisha radiallahu anha, the wife of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, otherwise they are basically denying the Quran, and they're outside the fold of Islam if they do that, because they're denying the verses in the Quran that talks about this. And as we heard, you know, more than one verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is reminding the believers that it's by the bounty of Allah and the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that the believers are in the state where they're in. This incident was a very heavy one at the time of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and it affected the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and Aisha radiallahu anha and the companions in large. And that's why there are many benefits for people to learn from it, and that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لا تحسبوه شرا لكم بل هو خير لكم. Do not count it as an evil thing for you, but rather is a good one. That's why these verses were revealed, and people get to learn some of these rulings by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, by the revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And towards the end of what we heard, there are evil people in every society. These people, those who love to spread evil doings, we have to be warned against them. Those who love to spread sins in a society, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying that they have a severe punishment in this life and in the hereafter, and it's by the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that a person is protected. We continue inshallah ta'ala with more of the verses of Surah An-Nur with Sheikh Ahmad Rajab, so please go ahead and continue with the verses.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا تتبعوا خطوات الشيطان، ومن يتبع خطوات الشيطان فإنه يأمر بالفحشاء والمنكر، ولولا فضل الله عليكم ورحمته ما زكى منكم من أحد أبدا ولكن الله يزكي من يشاء والله سميع عليم. ولا يأتل أولو الفضل منكم والسعة أن يؤتوا أولي القربى والمساكين ولا يأتل أولو الفضل منكم والسعة أن يؤتوا أولي القربى والمساكين والمهاجرين في سبيل الله وليعفوا وليصفحوا، ألا تحبون أن يغفر الله لكم والله غفور رحيم. إن الذين يرمون المحصنات الغافلات المؤمنات لعنوا في الدنيا والآخرة ولهم عذاب عظيم. يوم تشهد عليهم ألسنتهم وأيديهم وأرجلهم بما كانوا يعملون، يومئذ يوفيهم الله دينهم الحق ويعلمون أن الله هو الحق المبين. الخبيثات للخبيثين والخبيثون للخبيثات، والطيبات للطيبين والطيبون للطيبات، أولئك مبرؤون مما يقولون، لهم مغفرة ورزق كريم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا تدخلوا بيوتا غير بيوتكم حتى تستأنسوا وتسلموا على أهلها، ذلكم خير لكم لعلكم تذكرون. فإن لم تجدوا فيها أحدا فلا تدخلوها حتى يؤذن لكم، وإن قيل لكم ارجعوا فارجعوا هو أزكى لكم والله بما تعملون عليم. ليس عليكم جناح أن تدخلوا بيوتا غير مسكونة فيها متاع لكم، والله يعلم ما تبدون وما تكتمون.
ما شاء الله. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you. Nice recitation that starts with a call from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the believers. And again, the surah is called An-Nur, and it's really light after light if we follow the orders of Allah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants from the believers not to follow the steps of shaitan. Shaitan does not come all of a sudden, all at once, to take the people outside the fold of Islam. But rather, he goes slowly, one step after another. And the step that the shaitan would adorn for the person to do might be that one particular step, a good deed even. He might take the person to do something that is something good, something very nice. But the shaitan, he has a plan. He's taken the person one step after another to the sins and destruction of oneself. And wal'a'adhu billah, even disbelief. That's why following the steps of shaitan is a sinful thing and a person has to protect himself. But how would we know the steps of shaitan if the shaitan is someone that we do not see him and he sees us? The only way to be protected is to know the ways of shaitan, which is explained in the Quran, and the sunnah, the way of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Because the shaitan, he orders people to commit sins, and especially with the relationship between men and women, he won't come to a righteous person and whisper to him to commit zina, but rather he will come from one step to the other. And that's why in Islam it's very important from the very beginning the gaze is to be lowered, and to protect oneself from the evil within our own selves. And the surah teaches us this, as it will come inshallah ta'ala with regarding to lower the gaze, and the order from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for women to wear the hijab, and all of these things. Many people, they don't see the goal of it or the wisdom behind it, and they think it's just a matter of making our life more restricted. No, it's for the benefit of the society, for this ummah. As one of the scholars of the Deen of Al-Islam, when he was in the company of people that are politicians from Europe and so on, at the end of the Ottoman Empire, and they asked him, why your women are not sitting with us to mix like they would do? He said, because they don't want to have children out of wedlock. This is how things are. Although it sounds very harsh, but that's how society changes, one step after another, till they become very loose, and then you have children that are born out of wedlock, and they don't have any fortune whatsoever. They're not protected, there's no rights for them, and they think they are protecting the rights of these children, when the child, he deserves to have a mother and a father and a healthy family and so on. So many rulings and the wisdom of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is something that sometimes even we're not able to comprehend, because He's the most wise subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the most important thing is to follow the orders of Allah. And if a person do this, then that brings all kinds of goodness in this life and in the hereafter. And the story of Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu with Mistah ibn Athatha, as it's mentioned in the verse, because of the incident of Aisha radiallahu anha, also something that if we didn't talk about it now, maybe the viewers can go and search the story, something that shows the manners of a Muslim. When a person gives for the sake of Allah, he should continue to give for the sake of Allah, even if the one that gives, the one that is receiving, is someone that would do something of bad manners or so. Many benefits again, but we'll continue inshallah ta'ala with the recitation because of the time, and then we can talk more inshallah ta'ala about the verses. And we have inshallah ta'ala, we'll continue with the recitation with Sheikh Mahmoud Noor. So please go ahead and continue inshallah.
A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. قل للمؤمنين يغضوا من أبصارهم ويحفظوا فروجهم ذلك أزكى لهم إن الله خبير بما يصنعون وقل للمؤمنات يغضضن من أبصارهن ويحفظن فروجهن ولا يبدين زينتهن إلا ما ظهر منها وليضربن بخمرهن على جيوبهن ولا يبدين زينتهن إلا لبعولتهن أو آبائهن أو آبائهن أو آباء بعولتهن أو أبنائهن أو أبنائهن أو أبناء بعولتهن أو إخوانهن أو إخوانهن أو بني إخوانهن أو بني أخواتهن أو نسائهن أو نسائهن أو ما ملكت أيمانهن أو ما ملكت أيمانهن أو التابعين غير أولي الإربة من الرجال أو الطفل الذين لم يظهروا على عورات النساء ولا يضربن بأرجلهن ليعلم ما يخفين من زينتهن وتوبوا إلى الله جميعا أيها المؤمنون لعلكم تفلحون وأنكحوا الأيامى منكم والصالحين من عبادكم وإمائكم إن يكونوا فقراء يغنهم الله من فضله والله واسع عليم وليستعفف الذين لا يجدون نكاحا حتى يغنيهم الله من فضله والذين يبتغون الكتاب مما ملكت أيمانكم فكاتبوهم إن علمتم فيهم خيرا وآتوهم من مال الله الذي آتاكم ولا تكرهوا فتياتكم على البغاء إن أردنا تحصنا لتبتغوا عرض الحياة الدنيا ومن يكرهن فإن الله من بعد إكراههن غفور رحيم ولقد أنزلنا إليكم آيات مبينات ومثلا من الذين خلوا من قبلكم وموعظة للمتقين.
Inshallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you for this nice recitation. And with more of the rulings and the lights that are mentioned in the surah, and from the previous section, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered the believers and showed them the etiquettes of even going to somebody's house or somebody's place. And this is something that you see Quran revealed because of this, which shows the importance of manners and dealing with others is part of the religion of Islam, and that the religion is not just some acts of worship to be done, but rather the entire life of a Muslim. He conducts his life according to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran and in the best example, which is the life of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. What was discussed in these verses briefly, we'll talk about it inshallah ta'ala right after the break, so stay with us inshallah.
وإذا قرئ القرآن فاستمعوا له وأنصتوا لعلكم ترحمون.
Almighty revealed this book as a source of guidance, spirit, and direction to all mankind.
إن هذا القرآن يهدي للتي هي أقوم
Indeed, this book guides towards that which is the straightest. And Allah Ta'ala told us the reason behind revealing it. كِتَابٌ أَنزَلْنَاهُ إِلَيْكَ مُبَارَكٌ لِيَدَّبَّرُوا آيَاتِهِ. This book, this scripture is full of blessing. And the reason behind revealing it is for people to ponder on it. And men of understanding may reflect. وَلِيَذَّكَّرَ أُولُو الْأَلْبَابِ.
Join us on our brand new program titled Live Your Life, and I will be your host. It's going to be a beautiful journey through the blessed book of Allah. We're going to start from Al-Fatiha and work our way down and look at the very last verse that was revealed to the blessed Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessings be upon him. Let's not forget the great teachings of the blessed Prophet, where he said that the best
وَإِذَا قُرِئَ الْقُرْآنُ فَاسْتَمِعُوا لَهُ وَأَنصِتُوا لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ.
Alhamdulillah, salatu wassalamu ala Rasulullah. Welcome back, and still with the verses from Surah An-Nur, the light that we all should seek and try to have it in our hearts, and accordingly with our speech and actions. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless us all with the Quran. And the last set of verses we heard was about ordering the believers, believing men and women, to lower their gaze. And that order is come from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Most High, the one that knows best what is best for the human beings. And that's why this is one of the etiquettes that many people are ignoring in their life. They don't lower their gaze. And lowering the gaze is not just in the masjid, or in a specific situations at all times. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the exceptions, those muharim, those blood relatives, where it's permissible for the person to mix and so on. Otherwise, the order from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the believing women to observe the hijab. The hijab is a way of life. It's not just a piece of cloth that a woman would wear, because it has to have conditions to be fulfilled. It's a way to conceal the beauty of the woman from those men, those who are strangers to her, other than her maharim, her blood relatives, and so on. And this is by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the religion of Islam, for the Muslim woman to be righteous. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it easy for her. And more rulings in the verses. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought down these ayat, as he said subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَلَقَدْ أَنزَلْنَا إِلَيْكُمْ آيَاتٍ مُبَيِّنَاتٍ. We brought down to you ayat that are clear, not ambiguous. And sometimes the actions of some people, as if the statements and the speech of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not clear to them. No, the speech is very clear. And this Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it clear to us. And we have the way of the Prophet sallam, how the Prophet sallam and his companions implemented the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, amazingly, to show us perfectly how to be obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this admonition, this reminder, should find its place in our hearts, for us to humble ourselves to the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then the verse in Surah An-Nur that talks about the nur and the light of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is where we stopped, and we will hear inshallah ta'ala the beautiful recitation of these verses from Surah An-Nur with Sheikh Karim. So please go ahead and start the recitation.
A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. الله نور السماوات والأرض مثل نوره كمشكاة فيها مصباح المصباح في زجاجة الزجاجة كأنها كوكب دري يوقد من شجرة مباركة زيتونة لا شرقية ولا غربية زيتونة لا شرقية ولا غربية يكاد زيتها يضيء ولو لم تمسسه نار نور على نور
يهدي الله لنوره من يشاء ويضرب الله الأمثال للناس والله بكل شيء عليم في بيوت أذن الله أن ترفع ويذكر فيها اسمه يسبح له فيها بالغدو والآصال رجال لا تلهيهم تجارة ولا بيع عن ذكر الله وإقام الصلاة وإيتاء الزكاة يخافون يوما تتقلب فيه القلوب والأبصار ليجزيهم الله أحسن ما عملوا ويزيدهم من فضله والله يرزق من يشاء بغير حساب والذين كفروا أعمالهم كسراب بقيعة يحسبه الظمآن ماء حتى إذا جاءه لم يجده شيئا ووجد الله عنده فوفاه حسابه والله سريع الحساب أو كظلمات في بحر لجي يغشاه موج من فوقه موج من فوقه سحاب ظلمات بعضها فوق بعض إذا أخرج يده لم يكد يراها ومن لم يجعل الله له نورا فما له من نور ألم تر أن الله يسبح له من في السماوات والأرض والطير صافات كل قد علم صلاته وتسبيحه والله عليم بما يفعلون ولله ملك السماوات والأرض وإلى الله المصير ألم تر أن الله يزجي سحابا ثم يؤلف بينه ثم يجعله ركاما فترى الودق يخرج من خلاله وينزل من السماء من جبال فيها من برد فيصيب به من يشاء وينزل من السماء من جبال فيها من برد فيصيب به من يشاء ويصرفه عن من يشاء يكاد سنا برقه يذهب بالأبصار يقلب الله الليل والنهار إن في ذلك لعبرة لأولي الأبصار.
ما شاء الله. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you. Very nice recitation. As we heard, the verses talks about the light of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and beautifully explained. It's really, we cannot give it its rights. But after this ayah that talks about the light of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and this is also something for us to reflect upon. If you want to be among those who receive the light from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is the light of guidance, you will find it in fi buyutin adhin Allah an turfa, in the houses of Allah, in the masajid, in the places where the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is mentioned. This is the light that basically give the light to the entire world. If we don't go from the masajid to the entire world, then there is no light can be distributed really of guidance to humanity. This is why the believers, they start from the masjid. Their salah, their knowledge, their recitation of the Quran, all kinds of blessings, and they go to their homes with this light. They spread that light into their homes, into the streets, into the market, to the entire world with the guidance of the Quran. The Sahaba radiallahu anhum, they used to sit with the Prophet in the masjid. They pray with him, they learn from him, and they took this knowledge and they spread it all over the earth. And this is how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guided, and he made them means and sources of guidance. So these are the masajid where you would find in them رِجَالٌ لَا تُلْهِيهِمْ تِجَارَةٌ وَلَا بَيْعٌ عَنْ ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ وَإِقَامِ الصَّلَاةِ وَإِيتَاءِ الزَّكَاةِ يَخَافُونَ يَوْمًا تَتَقَلَّبُ فِيهِ الْقُلُوبُ وَالْأَبْصَارُ. Men, and we should also reflect on this word men, real men. The real men are the ones that trade and buying and selling would not take them away from the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is in the masajid and establishing the salah and giving the zakah. They fear a day when the day of judgment, when the hearts and the eyes will be turned over as a sign of the horrors of the day of judgment, where people again will be into two groups, the believers versus the disbelievers. The disbelievers in this life are deceived. They think they can see and they can hear, and relating this to the light, the disbelievers are in darknesses. They think that they can see and there's light in their life, but in reality they don't. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned that in verse number 39, that their actions كَسَرَابٍ بِقِيعَ, like the mirage. When a person is in the desert, it's not really anything. He thinks it's water when it's nothing. Or darknesses أَوْ كَظُلُمَاتٍ فِي بَحْرٍ لُجِّي, they are not just in one darkness, in darknesses. And this is how the Quran makes us see things in the right way. So the light and the guidance is in the Quran, in the way the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in the lives of the believers, if they follow this, and darknesses is the ways of the disbelievers. So why be deceived? Why imitating the ways of the disbelievers, and we think that they are on something? They are in darknesses. They are in need of the light of the deen of Islam. And when we see things are turned around in the other way, then this is the real misery in this life. Again, great benefits that we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us benefit from it. And inshallah ta'ala, we'll continue with the recitation with Sheikh Ahmad Rajab. So please go ahead and continue inshallah ta'ala with the ayat of Surah An-Nur.
A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. Wallahu khalaqa kulla dabbatin min فمنهم من يمشي على بطنه ومنهم من يمشي على رجلين ومنهم من يمشي على أربع يخلق الله ما يشاء إن الله على كل شيء قدير لقد أنزلنا آيات مبينات والله يهدي من يشاء إلى صراط مستقيم ويقولون آمنا بالله وبالرسول وأطعنا ثم يتولى فريق منهم من بعد ذلك وما أولئك بالمؤمنين وإذا دعوا إلى الله ورسوله ليحكم بينهم إذا فريق منهم معرضون وإن يكن لهم الحق يأتوا إليه مذعنين أفي قلوبهم مرض أم ارتابوا أم يخافون أن يحيف الله عليهم ورسوله بل أولئك هم الظالمون إنما كان قول المؤمنين إذا دعوا إلى الله ورسوله ليحكم بينهم أن يقولوا سمعنا وأطعنا وأولئك هم المفلحون ومن يطع الله ورسوله ويخشى الله ويتقه فأولئك هم الفائزون وأقسموا بالله جهد أيمانهم لئن أمرتهم ليخرجن قل لا تقسموا طاعة معروفة إن الله خبير بما تعملون قل أطيعوا الله وأطيعوا الرسول فإن تولوا فإنما عليه ما حمل وعليكم ما حملتم وإن تطيعوه تهتدوا وما على الرسول إلا البلاغ المبين وعد الله الذين آمنوا منكم وعملوا الصالحات ليستخلفنهم في الأرض كما استخلف الذين من قبلهم وليمكنن لهم دينهم الذي ارتضى لهم وليبدلنهم من بعد خوفهم أمنا يعبدونني لا يشركون بي شيئا ومن كفر بعد ذلك فأولئك هم الفاسقون وأقيموا الصلاة وآتوا الزكاة وأطيعوا الرسول لعلكم ترحمون لا تحسبن الذين كفروا معجزين في الأرض ومأواهم النار ولبئس المصير
Inshallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you. Very nice recitation. And again with more of the verses that really every verse is something is a treasure by itself. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioning some of the universal signs that everybody can see and relate to and for people to take lessons from it and to be reminded to humble themselves to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then some of the verses that really differentiate between those who receive the light from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the light of guidance, and those who don't, the hypocrites. How the believers, they submit themselves to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and how the hypocrites, they say we believe, they say that we are obedient, but then they turn away from the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala negated faith or al-iman from them. And if they are called to Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to judge between them, you would find them turning away. This is the sign of hypocrisy. The believers, whenever they are called to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to judge between them by the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they submit themselves. The hypocrites, they don't. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave them three choices. Either they have a disease in their heart, or they are in doubt with regards to the deen of Allah, or do they fear that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will treat them with injustice? This is basically the analysis of someone turning around from the orders of Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Bluntly like that. Not someone that overpowered by a sin and he committed a sin and he regrets. No, someone that turns away from the deen of Allah. He doesn't want the deen of Allah to be the place or the thing of authority over him. Either he has a disease in his heart, or he is in doubt, or does he think that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not the most just, or the ruling of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then clearly shows how the believers, whenever they are called to Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to judge between them, and yaqulu sami'na wa ata'na. That's it. The matter is very simple and easy. We listen and we obey. We listen to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and we obey the orders of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Beautiful verses and the promise from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the believers, if they are obedient to Allah, that He would make them establish on the face of earth as the nations before, and their fear would be replaced by security, but with the condition they worship none but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they establish the salah, they give the zakah, obey the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, so that they would receive the mercy of Allah. Towards the end of the surah, and more etiquettes and more rulings and more benefits, we'll listen inshallah ta'ala to the recitation of Sheikh Mahmoud Noor. So please go ahead and recite inshallah for us.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا ليستأذنكم الذين ملكت أيمانكم والذين لم يبلغوا الحلم منكم ثلاث مرات من قبل صلاة الفجر وحين تضعون ثيابكم من الظهيرة ومن بعد صلاة العشاء ثلاث عورات لكم ليس عليكم ولا عليهم جناح بعدهن ليس عليكم ولا عليهم جناح بعدهن طوافون عليكم بعضكم على بعض كذلك يبين الله لكم الآيات والله عليم حكيم وإذا بلغ الأطفال منكم الحلم فليستأذنوا كما استأذن الذين من قبلهم كذلك يبين الله لكم آياته والله عليم حكيم والقواعد من النساء اللاتي لا يرجون نكاحا فليس عليهن جناح أن يضعن ثيابهن غير متبرجات فليس عليهن جناح أن يضعن ثيابهن غير متبرجات بزينة وأن يستعففن خير لهن والله سميع عليم ليس على الأعمى حرج ولا على الأعرج حرج ولا على المريض حرج ولا على أنفسكم ولا على أنفسكم أن تأكلوا من بيوتكم أو بيوت آبائكم أمهاتكم أو بيوت إخوانكم أو بيوت أخواتكم أو بيوت أعمامكم أو بيوت أعمامكم أو بيوت عماتكم أو بيوت أخوالكم أو بيوت خالاتكم أو ما ملكتم مفاتحه أو ما ملكتم مفاتحه أو صديقكم ليس عليكم جناح أن تأكلوا جميعا أو أشتاتا فإذا دخلتم بيوتا فسلموا على أنفسكم فإذا دخلتم بيوتا فسلموا على أنفسكم تحية من عند الله مباركة طيبة كذلك يبين الله لكم الآيات لعلكم تعقلون إنما المؤمنون الذين آمنوا بالله ورسوله وإذا كانوا معه على أمر جامع لم يذهبوا حتى يستأذنوه إن الذين يستأذنونك أولئك الذين يؤمنون بالله ورسوله فإذا استأذنوك لبعض شأنهم فأذن لمن شئت منهم واستغفر لهم الله إن الله غفور رحيم لا تجعلوا دعاء الرسول بينكم كدعاء بعضكم بعضا قد يعلم الله الذين يتسللون منكم لواذا فليحذر الذين يخالفون عن أمره أن تصيبهم فتنة أو يصيبهم عذاب أليم ألا إن لله ما في السماوات والأرض قد يعلم ما أنتم عليه ويوم يرجعون إليه فينبئهم بما عملوا والله بكل شيء عليم
ما شاء الله may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you for this nice recitation. This is the end of Surah An-Nur with more instructions and more calls from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the believers, and that is to the young and the old and everybody to have the light of etiquettes of how to deal with one another. The order from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the young ones to seek permission before they enter, the three specific times throughout the day that the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered for the men, for the parents, for the mother and the father to be protected, their privacy, for the children to take permission or to ask permission before they enter, with the details of that, the rulings of the hijab for the very old and how that this can be relieved a little bit, not something that is would cause harm or so. This is also by the ruling from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and more with the rulings of visiting one another and eating with one another. But the point towards the end of the surah is how the respect and the and the obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the etiquette with the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forbade the believers from just calling the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with his name, but rather to say, Ya Rasulullah, O Messenger of Allah, and the like of this. And warning those who differ against the orders of the Prophet ﷺ that a fitna would afflict them or a severe punishment. So this is a severe warning for those who differ, goes against the way of the Prophet ﷺ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best what everybody does and what the intentions of people and so on. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us benefit from Surah An-Nur and to give us light in this life and in the Day of Judgment to enter the Jannah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa sallallahu wa sallam wa barak ala Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
إلا مبشرا